What's up guys, hope you're doing well. After installing Render Setter with the installer supplied, in Maya UI, you will find a new shelf tab named Render Setter. Open RS by clicking on the icon. The interface is composed of the header with two arrows up and down that allow you to collapse or expand all the tab sections. Below that, all the different sections, frame rate, frame range, output resolution, workflow, samples, AOVs, and the footer with a secondary window about RS including this video overview, the contact mail for technical or licensing support, and my social links. So the first thing to mention is that RS is designed to really speed up your render setup, like that you can focus on the other important things, not the boring and repetitive ones. RS will become your essential toolkit during your look development and render setup. Okay guys, let's see Render Setter in action and how to use it. So already after launching it, some things have been configured in background. If I open the render settings window, just to illustrate some of them. As you can see, the file name prefix is already filled up, and also the full HD resolution for the image size. I will keep the render settings opened for the sake of demonstration purpose, but of course no need to have it opened. Okay, so back to RS panel. The first tab is the frame rate. A toggle switch to change easily the frame rate, and it works correspondingly with the frame range. So next tab is frame range. Just input the two numbers of the sequence, like 1, 250, and click on set. As you can see in the render settings window, it has configured the start and end frame for the render and switched the frame animation extension. But it has also refreshed the time slider on the bottom of Maya interface. Now, as mentioned before, if we go back to the frame range tab section and we change it to 30 FPS, for example, it will keep the start and end frame value and refresh everything. Next up, the output resolution tab. Here we have a quick button presets with all the common resolution and ratios. No need to search for it anymore. So just click on the resolution you need and then the ratio. For example, 2K in 235 or maybe 8K in 239. Again, as you can see, it automatically refreshes everything in the render settings window. Next tab is if you need custom output resolution. Just input the height and width of the resolution. To make your life even more easier, I've made a resolution and aspect ratio sheet that you can consult by clicking on this button. All the common aspect ratio and pixel resolution are displayed. So for example, a 4K UHD with a 2:37 ratio is 3840 by 1620. Let's input that and click on set. Boom, easy as that. Next up, the workflow tab. You can switch between Nuke and After Effects workflow. This will merge or not the AOVs based on the workflow. Then a really important section, the sampling presets. You can quickly switch quality presets based on your needs. Again, as you can see in the render settings window, it configures everything accordingly. For example, if you are doing some look development, use low quality for fast iteration in the IPR. Those are the default values for the presets. But you can reconfigure every sample presets as you like by clicking this button. A new window opened. Every tab is relative to its own preset. Let's take the production quality preset for example. You've got the different channels. So for example, you want to lower the transmission to 1 and the subscattering surface to 0. Now you just have to save by clicking on the save configuration button. Now if we click on the production preset, as you can see it has updated the settings. These edits are saved on your computer. So next time you will launch Render Setter, it will keep your preferences. If you want to go back to the default settings, just reopen the samples editor and click on reset button. Then the last and also important section, the AOVs presets. You can quickly create a list of AOVs by using 3 presets based on your needs. Again, as you can see in the render settings window, it configures everything accordingly. Those are the default values for the presets. but you can reconfigure every AOV's presets as you like by clicking this button. A new window opened. Every tab is relative to its own preset. Let's take the extra preset for example. We've got the most useful AOVs. You can activate or deactivate every single AOV. Again, click on the Save Configuration button. Now, if we click on the extra preset, as you can see, it has updated everything. These edits are also saved on your computer. So here we are, this is Render Setup plugin. Hope you will find it useful as myself. That's all for the overview, folks. Thank you for your attention. And let's go create some exciting stuff.